is what you want from me. Take my heart and form it. Take my mind, transform it. Take my will, conform it. To yours, O Lord. Faithfulness, faithfulness is what I long for. Faithfulness is what I need. Faithfulness, faithfulness is what you want from me. Take my heart and form it. Take my mind, transform it. Take my will, conform it. To yours, O Lord. Righteousness, righteousness is what I long for. Righteousness is what I need. Righteousness, righteousness is what you want from me. Take my heart and form it. Take my mind, transform it. Take my will, conform it. To yours, O Lord. Brokenness, brokenness is what I long for. Brokenness is what I need. Brokenness, brokenness is what you want from me. Take my heart and form it. Take my mind, transform it. Take my will, conform it. To yours, O Lord. To yours, O Lord. To yours, O Lord.
Good morning, and welcome to the United Baptist Church here in Topsom, Maine. My name is Barbara Anderson, and I'm a deacon here at the church. This morning, I am filling in for Pastor Jim, who is away. I'd like to give welcome and greetings from all of us here at United Baptist, and we're glad that you have stopped in to visit with us this morning. Just a couple of announcements. I want to remind you that on October 6th, 7th, and 8th, we will be having a church revival event here at the church, and we invite you all to participate. And coming up on October 14th at 7 p.m. will be Mark Schultz in concert at the China Lake Baptist Camp that we support. This is a fundraiser for our camp, and we hope that you will come join us on this evening as well. You can find information on tickets at markschultzmusic.com. This morning, I am going to be sharing about beauty in brokenness. As we prepare for this morning's message, I just wanted to share just a little bit as we get into this sermon about when I was a child and how I always loved the beach. My mom had to pull me out of the water because I would never come out. She claimed that my lips were turning blue because the water was so cold. I also loved collecting shells on the beach. It was fun to see how many shells I could collect on vacation and how many different kinds I could find. Mussels, clams, snail shells, angel wings, periwinkles, and more. But the prize was when I could find a sand dollar, the coveted sand dollar. everyone wanted one. I saved my shell collection for years, and I even used them in high school for biology science projects. I always wanted to be a marine biologist when I grew up. How I love my times at the beach. It is my special place with God. It is where I hear him best in a broken world. As an adult, I still love the beach. Is it any wonder that my husband Phil and I moved to Maine when the time was right? Now, I no longer stay in the water till my lips turn blue, but I love to walk the beach and continue to collect shells. When my daughter Carrie was little, we would continue to go on vacations in Maine, and we would walk together on the beach hunting for shells. We still do, actually. I was determined that we would find that sand dollar together. As we walked along the beach, she would stop and pick up a shell and then place it in her bucket. As she kept stopping and placing things in her bucket, I noticed she was picking up broken shells along with whole ones. I explained to her that we were only looking for whole shells, that we didn't collect the broken ones because there was no beauty in them. She looked at me and said she liked them. They were pretty. And she continued along the beach, picking up those broken shells. Each of us is broken, living in a broken world. And our world constantly sets us up for failure by its expectations, only to place another crack in our shell. How do we see beauty in a broken world? How do we recognize our uniqueness and beauty and not wallow in our brokenness? May the Lord show us our beauty this morning through his words and how through him we can become whole in a broken world. Let us pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity to come together this morning, whether in person or through technology. Open our eyes, our ears, and our hearts to your message to us this morning. Remind us each day of our beauty and uniqueness in our broken world, and share our beauty and brokenness with those around us. Amen. This morning's scripture comes from Psalm 34. I will extol the Lord at all times. His praise will always be on my lips. I will glory in the Lord. Let the afflicted hear and rejoice. Glorify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord and he answered me. He delivered me from all my fears. Those who look to him are radiant. Their faces are never covered with shame. This poor man called, and the Lord heard him. He saved him out of all his troubles. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him, and he delivers them. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the one who takes refuge in him. For the Lord, you, his holy people, for those who fear him lack nothing. The lions may grow weak and hungry, but those who seek the Lord lack no good thing. Come, my children, listen to me. I will teach you the fear of the Lord. Whoever of you loves life and desires to see many good days, keep your tongue from evil and your lips from telling lies. Turn from evil and do good. Seek peace and pursue it. The eyes of the Lord are on the righteous, and his ears are attentive to their cry. But the face of the Lord is against those who do evil, to blot out their name from the earth. The righteous cry out, and the Lord hears them. He delivers them from all their troubles. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit. The righteous person may have many troubles, but the Lord delivers him from them all. He protects all his bones. No one of them will be broken. Evil will slay the wicked. The foes of the righteous will be condemned. The Lord will rescue his servants. No one who takes refuge in him will be condemned. Every seashell has a story. And like seashells, each of us is unique. We come in all shapes and sizes, and we may try to cover our brokenness by masquerading as a perfect shell, but God can see our brokenness. Many of you know that God has called me to a ministry working with exploited and trafficked women in Massachusetts and in Maine. I have seen brokenness in so many different forms. I wonder if hope can get through the darkness. Both organizations that I am affiliated with, All Hands in Massachusetts, and the Bridges to Blessing program with the Salvation Army here in Midcoast, Maine, has the emphasis on offering spiritual healing and wellness to women. Not many organizations concentrate on spiritual healing and offering a relationship with Jesus Christ to transform and heal the brokenness to wholeness. Through retreats, Bible studies, books, building one-on-one relationships, we share the love of Christ, beauty that makes its way through the cracks of our brokenness. One of my favorite books that I share with women when we are together is My Beautiful Broken Shell by Carol Hamblett Adams. She begins her book with taking a walk along the beach and passing by a broken scallop shell in search of more perfect ones. But she goes back to that broken shell, and this is what she writes. I realize that this shell is me with a broken heart. This shell is people who are hurting, people who have lost loved ones, people who are frightened or alone, people with unfulfilled dreams. This shell has had to fight so hard to keep from being totally crushed by the pounding surf, just as I have to. Yet this shell is still out on the beautiful shore, just as I am. God has a purpose for each of us, and going through our trials of brokenness somehow allows us to find the beauty of being broken. Carol Adams continues to write, "If our world were only filled with perfect shells, we would miss some of life's most important lessons along the way. We would never learn from adversity, from pain, from sorrow." Growing up in the 60s and 70s, I learned to be successful in life, you need to attend college, get married, have a career, buy a house, and have children. Women could do it all. So, of course, when I married Phil 41 years ago, my goals were set. Phil and I had jobs, and we went to church every Sunday. I taught Sunday school, Phil sang in the choir, and on the outside, we looked like a perfect shell. But when I measured my accomplishments against the world's expectations, I felt like a failure, broken. I hadn't finished college. I had a good job, but it wasn't a career. And the price of houses went sky high, and it was going to be a while before we could afford one. Well, one goal I could certainly accomplish would be to start a family. So Phil and I agreed it was time to start our family. And a year went by, and nothing happened. So I began seeing doctors and trying different things to get pregnant, but nothing happened. This went on for quite a few years. Now, the beauty in all of this was that God was growing our faith and preparing us to serve him in a variety of ways. But we had no idea at the time. I eventually went through in vitro fertilization several times, and I indeed got pregnant, but I couldn't sustain the pregnancy. The last time that I got pregnant, I actually made it through the first trimester, but then I lost it. Yes, I felt very broken through all of this. Something simple for so many, but impossible for me. As I sat in many a waiting room going through procedures, there were many women so much older than I was who had been doing this for years and were determined to get pregnant and have a baby. This had taken over their lives, an obsession. Watching and listening to these women as I was going through the same thing taught me to have compassion for others, to understand how they felt, to sympathize with them, to pray for them, to cry with them. I realized that through my brokenness, it was okay to cry, okay to share my feelings, to listen. As a Christian, I always thought I had to stand strong and not show my emotions because my faith would look weak. It's not my faith that was weak. It was my brokenness. God can heal the brokenhearted. He brought beauty to Phil and I through our miracle daughter, Carrie, who we adopted as a baby from China and is now 26. Even though I try not to measure my perfection through the world's eyes, I now have 2 college degrees, a house, a child, but not a career, but a ministry serving God. I want you to understand that I do not make light of brokenness. We live and are part of a broken world. By finding beauty in our brokenness does not change how we feel. Dealing with the anger, grief, sorrow, or whatever feelings we might have, you cannot put a Band-Aid on it and it will heal. It's not that simple. The beauty that we are able to find when we face our brokenness will help in the healing of ourselves and perhaps others. If I was to look at my journey of infertility as a broken shell on the beach, the surf was constant pounding on my soul. Carol Adams says that broken shells means lots of tears, lots of pain, lots of struggles. But they are also valuable for teaching faith, courage, and strength. Broken shells inspire others and demonstrate the will to go on in a way that no perfect shell could ever do. Broken shells are shells that have been tested and tried and hurt, yet they don't quit. They continue to be. I truly believe that God used my journey to prepare me for something more, to feel and understand the exploited woman in a different way. Their tears have become my tears. Their brokenness has become my brokenness. Yet seeing their healing and growth brings great joy and beauty to my soul. It is such a gift. Broken shells teach us not to look at our imperfections, but to look at the beauty, the great beauty of what is left. Carol Adams prays, "Thank you, Lord, for all that I learned from my brokenness. for the courage it takes to live with my pain, and for the strength it takes to remain on the shore. As I was leading a retreat for survivors last spring, we had a couple of new women in the group. I didn't know much about them, but they were eager to be there and to be a part of our retreat. One woman in particular was excited. She wanted to go home and find a church. She wanted to study the Bible. But what I didn't realize is that she didn't have a Bible. One of the other retreat attendees who had been coming for several years picked up on the situation. And at the end of the retreat, I noticed this veteran of the group walking over to the newbie and handing her her Bible to take home with her. The beauty that radiated from both of them was such a gift to me in my own brokenness, and a reminder that we are truly not broken, but we are whole through God's Son, Jesus. God gives us the opportunity to accept his Son, Jesus Christ, as our personal Savior. Jesus died on the cross for our salvation, that we may have eternal life and become whole. John 3:16 states, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him will not perish, but have everlasting life." And let us not forget in Psalm 34 that we read earlier to praise God in our brokenness, that he will not abandon us. We are to turn from evil to good. We are to seek peace and pursue it. God is close to the brokenhearted, and he will save those who are crushed in spirit. In our brokenness, we need the Lord. We need one another. Thank you, Lord, for filling my life with people who care. Thank you for my family and for my friends, for those who are always there for me. Give me strength to reach out and share my brokenness with others. Lord, help me to reach out to others, especially to the broken and discouraged, not only to love them, but to learn from them as well. May I listen, comfort, and give unconditional love to all who pass my way. May I realize I am not the only one hurting. We all have pain in our lives. Help me to remember that in my brokenness, I am still whole and complete in your sight. Thank you, Lord, for embracing my shell, whether I am whole or in my brokenness. Thank you for holding me in the palm of your hand, for keeping me safe as the pounding surf continues to surround me. As you and I continue to walk the beach of life, may we always remember each shell tells a story. My story, your story. We may not see the beauty in our own brokenness, but someone will. May we not just see the perfect and whole sand dollars on our walk, but to see the beauty in each broken piece on the sand that will lead us on the journey to wholeness in Jesus Christ. Amen. Can we pray together? Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time with you this morning. We thank you that you bring us wholeness in a broken world. May we continue to look for the beauty in our brokenness and share your love with others. Can we together now pray the Lord's Prayer? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.